Hi, my name is Dr. Becky Kuhn. I'm a physician who specializes in HIV/AIDS. Welcome to Prevention for Positives. This video is intended for individuals who are HIV positive and their partners, and will explain how to reduce your risk of transmitting or contracting HIV. HIV is a 100% preventable illness. It is important to remember that we all have the opportunity to help stop the spread of this deadly virus. If you are HIV negative, it is important to remember how HIV is transmitted and minimize your risk of contracting it through abstinence, being mutually faithful to one partner, using a condom for every sexual activity, including oral, genital, or anal, and for those who inject drugs, not sharing needles. Obviously, if you're in a culture where you do not have equal rights, you may not be able to follow these guidelines. Knowing your HIV status is the first step in making sure that you will never spread it. The U.S. government has even suggested that HIV testing be a part of a regular medical checkup. No matter who you are, if you do not know your HIV status, please get tested. You can either be tested confidentially or anonymously. Testing confidentially means that only you and your healthcare provider will know your name and test result. In the United States and many other countries, there are strong laws that protect the confidentiality of information between the healthcare provider and their patients. If you are concerned about confidentiality, in many places you can test anonymously. In anonymous testing, you do not disclose your name. You can contact your local health department for testing, and if they do not offer it on site, they will direct you to the nearest location. If you are HIV positive, you have the opportunity to make sure that HIV stops with you. Many of my patients have told me they do not feel safe telling their partners about their HIV status because they're afraid of being rejected. I can only imagine what it would be like to experience that fear. When you know your HIV status but don't disclose it, you may be carrying a burden. You have a chance to set that burden down by taking a stand and disclose your status to every potential partner. You create a freedom of choice that did not previously exist. You may be saying to yourself, I was not given that freedom of choice when I contracted HIV. Why should I give that freedom to someone else? You may not have had the knowledge at the time you contracted HIV. However, you now have the power to make sure that HIV stops with you. That may be the only power you feel like you have over your life at this time, and it's a good place to start. Make the decision today to let HIV stop with you. Another opportunity to have HIV stop with you is a suggestion from the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. They recommend that all newly diagnosed HIV-positive individuals voluntarily provide the names and contact details of all previous sexual partners to the local public health services. The list of partners includes both those who may have infected you and those you may have exposed to HIV. This notification creates the opportunity for the partners to receive counseling and testing for HIV. Participation in this program is entirely voluntary, and you can make the decision after you get your test results. You will never be required to provide the names of past sexual partners if you don't want to. I am often asked if there are any increased risks for two HIV-infected individuals having unprotected sex. This has been called serosorting. HIV-positive individuals having HIV-positive sexual partners instead of HIV-negative partners in order to prevent further spread of HIV. My answer is not very popular and sometimes not very well received. While the intention of serosorting may be good, preventing HIV-negative individuals from contracting HIV, the science does not support this practice as completely safe. There are many strains of the HIV virus, and any one individual may be carrying a different strain than their partner. In addition, over time, the HIV virus has been exposed to a number of different medications and has developed resistance. It has mutated or changed its shape so that those medications and possibly others in the same class or group are no longer effective. When two HIV-positive individuals exchange body fluids through unprotected sex, they run the risk of acquiring each other's virus. This is called superinfection. Since this is not a common occurrence, some individuals feel there's not enough evidence to warrant using condoms, even if both partners are HIV positive. Nonetheless, if you acquire another strain of HIV through a risky behavior, the odds are 100% for you. I've seen firsthand the effects of superinfection on a patient's CD4 count. It had been stable for many, many years. After an unprotected sexual encounter with another man in a foreign country, he developed a significant drop in his CD4 count, and it never recovered. Another way to increase the chances that HIV stops with you is if you are on antiretroviral medications, to take them at the dosages and on schedule as prescribed by your physician. When you take your medications as prescribed, you accomplish two things. You reduce the risk of developing resistance to the HIV virus. Secondly, you reduce the amount of virus in your body. It's called your viral load, hopefully to a non-detectable level. A lower viral load decreases your chance of transmitting HIV. Taking your medications as prescribed, however, is no substitute for safer sexual practices. Another way to increase the chance that HIV stops with you is to make sure that you and your partner do not have other sexually transmitted diseases. Studies have shown that having other sexually transmitted diseases at the time when you are having unprotected sex increases the risk of both transmitting and contracting HIV. Being free of other sexually transmitted diseases, however, is no substitute for safer sexual practices. Barriers such as condoms and dental dams are always a necessary part of safer sex. No matter who you are a valuable individual, and your life matters, as do the lives of those in your community. Take care of yourself and those around you. Make healthy choices that eliminate or reduce your risk of contracting or transmitting HIV. For AIDSvideos.org, this is Dr. Becky Kuhn.